Bible time again. It's Bible time again. Come find a spot and sit right down. It's Bible time again. Hi, friends. Can you guess who I am? I haven't seen you in a very long time, and sometimes a mask makes it a little tricky to see who's under here. Do you remember my name? Do you have any guesses? How about now? It's me, Miss Mariah. Even though my mask was covering part of my face, it's still the same person that God made me to be, just like you. I want to welcome you back to our ice cream stand. Did you eat any ice cream this week? I did. I love ice cream, but sometimes ice cream makes my tummy hurt. So sometimes I have to have special ice cream. This time I had it with strawberries and chocolate chips, and it was so yummy. But after I had my ice cream, I went to bed and I had some really funny ice cream dreams. In my dream, I put ketchup and pickles on my ice cream. Isn't that so silly? Have you ever had any silly dreams? Sometimes dreams can be silly, but sometimes they're really scary or they're funny. But our story today is about Joseph and how he helped Pharaoh because he had some really crazy dreams. But these dreams came from God. Do you remember the name of the special book that we have that comes from God? How about this? That's right, friends, the Bible. The Bible is God's word. What does the Bible say, Bible say, Bible say? What does the Bible say for us today? It says that God made me, God loves me, and Jesus wants to be my friend forever. That's right. God loves us, and he has a good plan for all of us. Our Bible verse this month reminds us of God's plan. Do you remember where our Bible verse is found? It starts with Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11, and it says, "For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord." For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. For I know the plans I have. Yes, I know the plans I have. For the know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. All right, friends, this week for our activity, we're talking about dreams and how Pharaoh needed Joseph's help to understand God's plan. Our Bible story today talks about how Pharaoh had some dreams he didn't understand. So he asked Joseph for some help because he knew that Joseph had a very special relationship with God. When Pharaoh had these dreams, it was God's way of telling them that there was going to be a lot of hunger in the years to come. So Joseph helped Pharaoh make a plan to make sure that the people didn't go hungry. So today we're going to do an activity with my friends here to make sure that our friends don't go hungry either. So we have our friend, Mr. Pig, a horse, a goat, and a cow. All right, friends, so let's make a plan to make sure that all of our animals have enough food to eat. All right, so here are their containers. All right, so what do you think of this plan? What if I give the horse, maybe this much, and the goat, maybe the horse needs more because he's a big animal, and the cow needs more because he's a big animal too. Okay, he'll probably be really hungry. We'll give some goat. Oh, and this for the pig. That plan doesn't seem very good, does it? Do you think it's a good plan? Probably not, right? They're not fair, and our pig and our poor goat will go hungry because they don't have enough food. Okay, let's try that again. All right. How do you think we could do this? Let's see. Okay, let's try and spread out our food again. So we know that the goat needs more food than we gave him the last time. So let's give him, let's give him lots more. Okay, Mr. Goat, there you are. All right, and for the pig, lots more. A little more for the goat, just in case. Wait a minute. Does this seem like a good plan? I don't have any food left, and our horse and our cow don't have any food. Do you think that's a good plan? Probably not. Let's try again. Okay, now let's see if we can make sure all of our friends have enough food. Okay. We'll start with that. Hopefully you don't make as much of a mess as I do, friends. All right, friends, what do you think about that? That looks like a good plan, doesn't it? All of our animals have enough food to make sure that they don't go hungry. Sometimes our plans don't always work out very well, but you know who always has the best plan? God always has the best plan. And in our Bible story, which takes place in Genesis 41, we can learn about how God's best plan helped Joseph and Pharaoh make sure that the people didn't go hungry.
Just follow me through.
Who?
Who?
Follow me through. Follow me through. Who? Ollie's got a Bible story for me and you.
Oh, hello, friends. I'm Casey, and I'm helping out at the cupcake food truck. Do you want to see my latest, most delicious creation? These are my sweet dreams cupcakes, because in today's story, we're going to talk about someone who had some pretty amazing dreams. If you're ready, on the count of three, yell, "Tell me a story." One, two, three, tell me a story! This is Joseph. He was put in jail, even though he had done nothing wrong. Being in jail was hard for Joseph, but God had a different plan. One day, the king of all of Egypt, the Pharaoh, had some dreams he didn't understand. They were about seven cows. Cows? What do cows say? Moo! You're right. Dreaming about cows is funny. Wait, let's count the cows in Pharaoh's dream. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven! Great job! Seven cows. The Pharaoh also dreamed about stalks of grain. Grain? We make bread out of grain. Let's pretend to have a snack. Yum. Yum! Pharaoh wanted to know what his dreams meant. And drum roll, please. He asked Joseph to help him. Hooray! Joseph was brought out of jail straight to the Pharaoh. He told Pharaoh that the dreams were from God, that Pharaoh needed to save lots and lots of grain because his people were going to be hungry and need it later. Pharaoh was so happy to know what his dreams meant that he gave Joseph a very special job. He put Joseph in charge of all of Egypt. Years later, the dreams came true. People were hungry and didn't have food, so they traveled from all over to get grain from Joseph. Wow! God's plan was for Joseph to help all these people. God has a plan for us too, and God's plan is the best plan. Did you like the story? If you did, give it two thumbs up. Two thumbs up! Hey, Ollie, tell me, who has a plan for you?
God has a plan for me. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who has a plan for you?
God has a plan for me. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. See you next time.
Wow, isn't that an awesome story? Pharaoh had some dreams that he knew came from God, and Joseph was able to help make sure that all the people got help because of God's plan. All right, friends, let's pray together. Let's see your wiggle fingers. One, two, three. Dear God, thank you for always having the perfect plan. Even when our plans don't work, we know that we can trust in you to have the perfect plan for us. We love you. Amen. I will trust in God. I will trust in God. Even when it's really hard, I will trust in God. All right, friends, now you get to join me. Get your clapping hands ready. I will trust in God. I will trust in God. Even when it's really hard, I will trust in God. Good job. Now let's sing one we all know. Deep and wide, God's love for me is deep and wide. Deep and wide, God's love for me is deep and wide. All right, and for our last song today, friends, let's go to our clubhouse video.
He's got a plan. He's got a
Yes, he does.
He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. That's what I know. That's what I know. That's what I know. That's what I know.
Let's go.
I know that I can trust him.
Yeah.
I know that I can trust him.
Yeah.
No matter what the season.
Yeah.
His plans are for a reason.
Yeah.
I know they are good. I know they are best. The reason I know is because he said he's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. That's what I know.
Oh, that's what I know.
That's what I know.
Oh, that's what I know.
And when I'm feeling so sad, hey, when I am afraid, God will never leave me. No, 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 His love will never change. I know they are good. I know they are blessed. The reason I know is because I said He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. That's what I know.
Oh, that's what I know.
That's what I know.
Oh, that's what I know.
All right, well, that's all for today, friends. Thanks for coming to Bible Time with me, and I hope that you remember that God always has a plan, and it's always the best plan. Bye!